So, good morning, children. Today again we are out here discussing of the history chapter 1 of class 12, that is bricks, bricks and bones. Till now we have discussed this chapter part wise, part 1, part 2, part 3. We have completed. Now we are moving on to next topic, that is craft production in Harappan civilization time. Now, what was the craft production they used to do? What was the technique was being used for making crafts? What shape was being given to each? What was the strategy for procuring the material? And apart from that, we will discuss their relation with different settlement or with different land out here. Now, let us start. Now, craft productions. Out here, that was the Chahanodaro. It was a very tiny settlement as compared to Mohenjo-daro, and this settlement was exclusively devoted in craft production. And what they used to make craft like beads making, sail cutting, metal working, deal making and weight making. That was the production this Chahanodaro used to make. Now, what was the material used to make beads? Like stone, like carnelian was there, that was very beautiful in red in color stone, crystal, quartz and stratotype. Now, apart from that, metal like copper, bronze and gold was also been used, and sail, fence and terracotta or brown clay was also been used to make beads. Some beads were made of two or more, some beads were there which was made of two or more stone which was been combined or joined together and given a nice shape. Some of the stone were used with gold cap, means a gold cap was within, and on top of that they used to place the gold stone for giving a beautiful shape. Now, what was shape given? Like it used to be found in disc shaped, cylindrically, spherical, barrel shaped, or segmented. Some were decorated by incising, by cutting, or cutting into different fine shapes, or by painting it. Some has design onto them. Some beads used to have design upon it. Now, what was the technique they used for making bead? That was the material required and the shape we have studied. Now, technique they use. Now, the technique was been used based upon the material. It was dependent upon the material they use the technique. So if the material is very short, based on that they make. If the material is very hard, on the based upon that they used to make a base. For example, stratotite was a stone, was a very soft stone. It can be crushed easily and make it into a powder. With this, some beads were molded out of paste. Some beads used to be molded and they used to make into a paste, and they used to make with stratotite powder, and they used to give a fine shape to it. Now, the red color carnelian was also because there red carnelian stone, that how it was been obtained by giving firing to the yellowish raw material used to be there. They used to fire upon that and it used to be turned into reddish colors, and beads of various stage of production was being used. Nodules were crepited into rough shapes and then finally flaked into the final form. Nodules, you must have seen the pea plant and all at the top, yellowish, the nodule was there. Like that, they used to give a shape or design clip into the base. And some archaeologists have said some stone used to be very hard. For that, they used the grinding, polishing and drilling was being used for to give a complete the process. Understood? That is, grinding, polishing and drilling was being done for the hard stone so that it could be given a final, that means a complete process has been done to give a final shape to that base. Now, Chahanodaro, Lothar and at Dholaviriya. Chahanodaro, Lothar and Dholaviriya. These were the center which was specialized for deal. Specialized deal was found in this three center. Apart from that, sale object of bangles, where this was been found, Nageshwar and Balakota. These two center was specialized center for making in sale object, that was like bangles. So in this way they used to make a base, and that was a technique used been. Now, strategy for procuring the material. So what was the strategy they used for procuring the material? How the material was being procured, we will discuss out here. Now, before that, it was in order to identify the particular center of craft production, they have, what the archaeologists have done, suppose this center is famous for this production, that center is famous for production sale, in that copper was being found, in that beads making or in that metal work was being done, found in that particular center, how it was been identified. So archaeologists have identified that particular center on the basis of the raw material found from that particular center. Raw materials such as stone, noodles, wholesale, copper, wood, tools, unfinished object, or unfinished object, it will mean, by unfinished object it means a rejected and the waste over material, the waste material, whatever was been thrown, from based upon that it was been identified the center. Now strategy, local available material was also been found out there. Yeah, locally available material was also been found out there, for on the basis of such as stone was there, timbers and metal had been procured from outside, and alluvial from the alluvial plain. Some locally available material was also like clay and all, based upon that if clay product was there, broken clay product or the clay product was been found, based upon that area was been devoted to the clay, means clay used to be found easily in that center, that means that particular center was for the clay, clay productions. On the basis of that, and they also have found by establishment settlement. Now establishment settlement of where raw material was available, other was that establishing settlement, that means the settlement was also been found in that particular center where the raw material was available. Like settlement was found in Nageshwar and Balakota, why in this, and from this Nageshwar and Balakota settlement was been found, why? Because in these two areas sale was been found easily, and they used to make the product with the help of this sale by sending expedition to areas such as the Khetri region of Rajasthan for copper and South India for gold. Now expedition means a journey of a person to other part for some other particular thing. They used to travel to the Rajasthan for copper, South India for gold, exchange of the things. For example, this is center A and this is center B. Now A is for copper and B is for gold. Now out here the copper production is going on, in B gold production is going on. Now if this copper will be found in B, that means gold will be found in A, it means it show that they were having some trade relation between these two center. Trade relation was going on. Now by establishing trade relation with other civilization, so in this way the trade relation was also been established with the evidence of a product or which has been found from A to at B and B at A. Now similarly, terracotta model of bullock cart was also been found, which suggested that this was an important means of transportation for the through the people to the across the land route. That means terracotta model of bullock cart was also been depicted in the seal, which gives us a suggestion that there was people used to travel from one place to other with the help of land route also. And the Harappan procured various material in various way, which I have said you right now, that was establishing settlement, means settlement used were been found in that particular nearby area where the material was easily available. And apart from that, some other expedition was also of area was also there by, from where they can easily transport the good from one place to another. That was the second, that means the this expedition established communication with local communities. Now let us move to the contact with distance land. Now contact with distance land, what does it mean by the contact with distant land? Contact with distant land, it suggests that they are having a contact with other region also apart from that their local area. So this is local area and this is other area, so it shows us that they are having the contact with this region. So how we can say that they are having the contact with this region? Like Harappan has trade relation. Now it suggests that Harappa was having trade relation with Mesopotamia, Oman and Bahrain. Why, how it has suggested us, let us discuss. Now evidence has provided including Harappan seal, weight, dyes and beads, depictions of ships and boat on seal. This all has suggested like Harappan seal was been found in all these places, and weight, dyes, beads, and these all are the production which wasn't found in different places. This is a production of different place. This wasn't found in Onam and all. And depiction of seal and boats on seal, that means during that period in the seal, the depiction of ships and boat was also been inculcated, and copper has also been probably found from Oman. Now, copper. This Onam was the region where the copper was been used to be found, which was the one archaeologists has suggested that copper was probably brought from Onam in the Harappan. From where? In the Onam on the southern eastern tips of the Arabian Peninsula. From the southern eastern tips of the Arabian Peninsula, from Onam, they used to part to southern eastern tips of the peninsula, they used to bring copper. Now, Onami coppers and Harappan artifact have trace of nickel. Now see, copper was been brought used to be available in Onam and Harappan, they are having the nickel. Now it suggests that copper was been found in Harappan and Harappan artifact of nickel was been found in Onam. That means it shows us that they are having the trade relation with Harappan and Onam. A distinctive type of vessel, a large Harappan jar coated with a thick layer of black clay, have been found in Onami site. So you can say this is a black clay. This clay pot, black clay, has been, this was a jar of Harappan. It used to be made in Harappa. So this was a black clay jar which was been found in Onami site. In the place of Onami, this has been was been found. Is by this it shows us that it was an evidence which suggests that they were having the trade relation with Onam. Means Harappan artifact was been taken by Onam and Onam copper was been brought to Harappan civilizations. Now, Harappan extends the content of the vessel from the Onami copper. Right now, I have said that Onam was famous for copper and Harappa was for making the Harappan artifact, that is a vessel of black jar, black coated jar. Onami used to take that black coated jar from Harappa and Harappa used to bring copper from Onami. Apart from that, Mesopotamia text also has datable to the 3rd millennium BC also referred that copper was coming from a region called Magam. This was also a region of Harappan. From there also copper was also be used to be brought. Not only that, Meluha was also the Meluha. This was also a small, possibly Harappan region from where the product used to be brought. What was used to be brought from that? Carnelian, lapis, lazuli, copper, gold, and varieties of wood used to be brought from this to the Harappan region. There was also a Persian girl's seal was found in Bahrain, sometimes carries Harappan motifs. Now, Persian seal which was found in Bahrain, they have seen. This Persian girl of seal was found in Harappa and Harappan motifs was been found in Bahrain. And apart from that, the transportation have also suggested us why transportation is been seen. It is likely that communication with, now this transportation, contact with distant land, now to have a contact with different center, how they were having the contact, that means there must be a transportation facility was there. So it means the transportation facility with Mesopotamia, Bahrain and Oman, to this center the transportation facility was, and we suggest us was transportation used to be done by sea, that is a seafare transportation. That means through the sea the transportation used to be done during this particular center. If they have to draw something from the Mesopotamia or something from the Bahrain or Oman, from where they used to do transportation from to the sea route. So out here, contact with the distant land, how the contact with distant land give us evidence, provide us. For example, Oman was, in the Oman center the copper used to be found, and in the Oman center copper used to be brought to the Harappan through on the southern eastern tips of the Arabian Peninsula. Southern eastern tips of the Arabian Peninsula, through that route copper used to be brought, and the Harappan used to make a jar of black coated that used to be taken by the Oman. So it suggests that they are having a trade relation and through the sea route. Apart from that, the Persian girl seal which was found in Bahrain also have a trace in Harappan, and Harappan motifs have a stress was been found in Bahrain. It also suggests that they are also having a trade relation. In this way, the trade relation of different country or different region centers they are having through the sea route. So today we have discussed regarding the craft production and the, how the craft production was been done. And which center was famous for the craft, or today devoted for the craft production, was Chahanudaro. And they used to make craft like sail cutting, metalwork, seal making, beads making and all. So what was the material required for the craft production? We have discussed like stone, like carnelian, crystal, quartz. This all was been used. And the technique was being used to make beads was depend upon the material. They used the technique for making beads. Now, how the archaeologists have identified the centers for production? The archaeologists have identified the center for production on the basis of the raw material available, on the basis of the, or on the basis of the raw material found on that center. Like the raw material includes stones, nodules, copper, ore, tools or unfinished product that was left over was been found on the basis of that they have found. And other one was on the basis of the settlement, also the craft production the archaeologists have found. That means when the nearby area where the raw material was been available, the settlement was been found in that particular center. And other strategy was procuring raw material was to send expedition to the area such as Khetra region of Rajasthan for copper, South India for gold. These are other evidence which suggests us that how the strategy was been used for procuring the material which archaeologists through the help of the archaeologists. Now contact with land also we have discussed how they are having the contact with land. They are exchanging their product or the raw material from one center to the other center, one country to another country through the sea route. So till this much, in the next class we will discuss regarding the seal scripts and wills. Thank you.